So this is a code walkthrough for the file OperatorsIntegerDivision.java, and I'll assume that you've already downloaded this from Canvas. So let's open this up in JGrasp, and let's take a quick eyeball of this file. Notice that we've got our declarations up at the top, as we should have, and notice that these are declarations only. We don't know what these values are going to be, so those will be established later on in the program. Here's a constant for cents per quarter, and again we're using the final keyword so that this value of 25 can't be changed. Notice that we've got relatively descriptive names, and we're using good camel case naming on all of these. In general, what we're doing here is we're taking one number and we're dividing it by some smaller number to try to figure out how many whole numbered times that smaller number will divide the larger number, and what's left over after integer division. So as always, what we'll do is we'll compile this, and I'm going to set a breakpoint by clicking in the margin next to public static void main, and that will enable us to click on this debug icon, and we will go ahead and step our way through this program. Now in this first problem, we're dividing 100 by 15, getting a result of 6. And then if we are using the modulus operator, we're getting the remainder, which is 10, and we're printing out our results. 15 goes into 100 6 times with 10 left over. Now in the second problem, we're trying to figure out how many whole boxes we can fill given a certain number of items. Let's say that 12 items go into a box, and we've got 126 items. How many boxes can we fill fully, and what's going to be left over? So again, we'll initialize those values, and notice here that we're reusing a couple of our variables, result and remainder. And notice what happens when we perform the division and modulus. Over here in the left pane, if a variable gets its value updated, it's going to get updated in red. So this is just showing us that we're overwriting the previous value of result with a result of 10 and a remainder of 6, and we'll print our results. So we can fill 10 boxes evenly at 12 items per box, and we'll have 6 items left over. Now in this last problem, let's imagine we've got 108 cents and we're trying to figure out how many quarters with a value of 25 we can get out of that 108 cents. So we'll divide by our constant 25 and we'll get a result of 4 and a remainder of 8. And again, we'll print our results, and with 108 cents, that'll be 4 quarters of value 25 cents each, with 8 pennies left over. So this just illustrates how to use the division and modulus operators when doing integer division.